Hello dear students, today we'll discuss about private company, public company. In Companies Laws Act 1913, as per that, they have described about private company. What is private companies described? They did not give any features of public company. Private company features are given. Which is not following these features of private company is a public company. This is what said. But if you compare it with public company and private company through a table, what is the difference between private company and public company? You will have a much clarity and understanding. So that is why I am going to share with you public company, private company, its distinction or differences between these two through a table. Now let's enter into the topic. So a distinction between private and public company. First base, what on what basis? Private company, public company. First point is that minimum number of persons. How many members are required to start a company? If it is a private company, minimum 2 members are required. If it is a public company, 7 members minimum. Minimum members are here 2, private 2, public 7, minimum members. If 2 members minimum are there, they can start the company. If 7 at least, not below. If 7 at least members are there to start the company, they can. Okay, so minimum members are 2 and 7. Next one, maximum number of persons. How much should be the maximum number of persons? If it is a private company, not more than 200. It should not cross 200. Maximum number is 200. Public company, no restriction. It can be anything. N number of persons can be members of the public company. Okay, private company 200 maximum. There, no restriction. Next one. Transferability of shares. Shares can be transferred or not. So if it is a private company, shares cannot be transferred. It's restricted. Shares cannot be transferred so easily. There are some restrictions that they have to follow. They have to take the acceptance. Then only it is possible to transfer the shares in private company. Whereas in public company, no restriction. Any time to anyone you can transfer the shares, need not to take the permission of anyone. For your kind information, few shares, there is no name, nothing is written, easily transferable. My name is not there. Whoever I want, I can just give it to them, they can purchase it. No name, no age, no phone number, address, nothing is there. Shares purchase document, that can be transferred easily. Without any restriction, it's possible in the public company. Next one is that prospectus. Prospectus will be preparing generally for issue of the shares. Prospectus. Private company cannot issue the shares. Where is the question of prospectus? So it cannot issue the prospectus in private company because they can't issue the shares. So they can't issue the prospectus. Prospectus, what is written means about the company details and how much shares they want, how much shares they wanted to issue, like full details of the company and company balancing position, like balance sheets of last 5 years, and lot more information is included in the prospectus. So the prospectus cannot be issued by the private company because they don't have right to issue the shares. Whereas in public company, it can issue. They can issue because they need shares. They have right to issue the shares. They have right to invite the shareholders to buy the shares from the company. So that is why they can issue the prospectus. Next one, minimum number of directors. Directors, how many members should be there? Minimum 2 here. Minimum directors 2. Here, public company 3. 2, 3. Easy to remember. Next one, retirement of directors. Every year, some number of directors has to retire. That kind of restriction is not there in the private company. Not required. Not required to retire the directors every year. But whereas in public company, at least two-third of directors on rotation basis every year they have to retire. Retirement of directors is two-third of directors on rotation basis they have to retire. But in private company, no restriction. They can continue because it's a private company. Next one is that quorum of meeting, quorum for meeting. Quorum for meeting means how many members minimum are required to conduct a meeting. For that, minimum 2 members in private company. Who are these 2 members? 2 members of shareholders. Minimum 2 shareholders are required in private company. Whereas in public company, it is 5. Minimum 5 members of shareholders are required to conduct any meeting. Next one, managerial remuneration. Management will be getting remuneration because of their services. How much it should be? Here in private company, no restriction. Managerial remuneration. Remuneration for management is, there is no restriction. How much they want, they can decide. There is no particular amount is decided by the government. But whereas in public company, it cannot exceed 11%. 11% of net profits. If they get a net profit of, suppose say 1 lakh, out of 1 lakh, 11% means 11,000. Means their remuneration, managerial remuneration should not cross 11,000. Profit is 1 lakh. 1 lakh, 11% is 11,000. It should not cross. Below 11,000 only, they have to take the remuneration. Who? Directors. Okay? So this is about the managerial remuneration. Next one is the public deposits. Public deposit. Private company cannot accept. So it cannot accept. Private company cannot issue any kind of shares to the public. So it cannot accept. Now here, they can accept. They can invite the public, normal people. They can invite the public to purchase their shares. So that is why we can say public deposits. They can invite, it's free of cost. So free to accept, they can accept it easily. So they have right, that's the one of the best quality of public company. Private company, they cannot issue any shares. Next one, paid up capital. Paid up capital means whenever the company want to start, minimum with this amount they have to start. That amount we call it as a paid up capital. Paid up capital, how much should be required? Minimum how much is required for the private company? It is 1 lakh. For private company it is 1 lakh. Whereas public company it is 5 lakh. Minimum, if they have 1 lakh rupee in the private company, they can start the company. Paid up capital should be this much. And in public company, minimum 5 lakh. Then only they can start the company. These are the main features of the private company, public company. You can pause the video and note down the content. If you know the differences, you can answer even what is public company, what is private company. If you get any essay question also, you can write because of this information. And also you may expect one question in the exam. Distinguish between private company and public company. Short one or big one, fill in the blanks, anywhere, short one, you can expect. Even a essay question also you can expect. So this is very important topic. Please learn. And in the description box, BOM, Business Organization Management, previous chapters and all the link is given downside. And also company law, there are many more subjects already I have covered. Please see the links in the description box and also in the playlist. Learn and enhance your career. Wish you good luck.